Power 93.7 WBLK. I'm Yasmin Young. This is the 2 to 6 Takeover. It is literally Bills mania because the Bills, the Buffalo Bills, have been doing phenomenal. And of course, Buffalo, Bills Mafia, everyone here in Western New York wants to support them. And I'm not a big football person, but I do love to eat. And I'm so happy to be joined today by Chef Darian. He's personal chef for Stephon Diggs, and he also does food services for some of the other Bills players. Welcome, Chef Darian.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. Appreciate it.
I appreciate, like I said, I love to eat, and looking at your Instagram page, I was like, oh, I don't think I can afford him, but can I get a little piece of something?
You know, I tell most people, you know, just save your money because it's worth it, you know what I mean?
So tell us a little bit about you. I know you came from Jamaica. Were you a chef there, or did you get started here in the U.S.?
I always loved cooking as a kid back in Jamaica. My mom used to have a cook shop in Jamaica, and used to help her all the time in the cook shop. And I'm like, I really like this. So when my mom left Jamaica, she came to the U.S. I took over at like 15, and I was doing all the meals out of the little cook shop. And I'm like, I think I want to be a chef. Then I started experimenting with my grandparents. Like, I used to make them these weird stuff for them to try, and they do like it. I'm like, I see the joy that food brings to people's faces. I'm like, you know what? This is what I want to do for the rest of my life. So from that, let's work towards it. So I came here when I was 20, and I went to school at ECC for 2 years. Then from there, moved to Buff State. It was at Hutchins for 4 years, Prima Cafe in Hamburg, then Fisher Price, then my own thing.
Well, that's a big difference climate-wise, and I'm guessing probably food-wise too, coming from Jamaica to Western New York.
Yeah, it's an eye-opener for me because, as what I said before, my previous articles, it's like, man, there's so many stuff here that have different name here than Jamaica, so it was like so hard for me, like avocado and pear. I'm like, they're like, get me some avocado. I'm like, what's avocado? They're like, it's in front of you. I'm like, I don't see no avocado in front of me. So it's like, it's just so much for me to learn coming here from Jamaica because, you know, as what I said, I never seen pancake before. I never seen all of those stuff. And then it was my first job, my very first job in the country. And knowing breakfast food, I'm like, man, there's so much out there that I need to know. So I just, you know, spend time on myself every day, practicing, reading books, researching stuff, and trying different food.
You know, it's paid off. We can say that. It's definitely paid off for you. So, you know, everybody wants to know, what are some of the Bills players' favorite dishes? What is it? I mean, because they've got to eat not only just to, you know, for the joy of eating and satisfying their taste, but it's also part of their job as far as maintaining their muscle, their weight, all of that.
Yeah, it's tricky because some of these guys, they're different. Some want just straight up like grains and lean meat. And some guys just want to, you know, they want the pasta, stuff that's going to keep them chewing, you know, like the day. Like, I know Diggs for sure, he love like breakfast food. That's his thing. Love breakfast with dinner. Love oxtail. Love seafood. And Gabe is the same too. He love oxtail, love seafood, pasta. So, you know, all of those stuff, like, so keep them firm and strong throughout these games. And some guys just want, that's what I said before, they want like quinoa, farro, chicken breast, turkey breast, bison steak, nothing with fat, you know. So they have different diets that have to cater to all of their needs. Like, some of them is vegan, so they have to cook vegan dishes. So I have to be all over the place with my cuisine and dishes so that they can be happy with whatever they get, you know.
And that's awesome, though, because I think that as provides, I'm guessing, a challenge for you every day, you know, of cooking, like you said, all over the place. And of course, having to make it taste great. So let's talk about game day dishes. You know, what are some of your favorite game day dishes that are, let's go with some that are fairly easy to make, you know, that someone at home right now can say, you know what, I'm gonna whip that up tomorrow.
You know, the thing with me, I like to be creative with whatever I do. Like, if I do, like, some type of pasta dish, like an Alfredo, which I made my Alfredo from scratch, I put something fun on it, like an arancini ball or, you know, stuff with something. So, because they want all of that carbs, you know, because before the game, you know, because you got to stay firmer and strong here in Buffalo. You know, you got to fight the cold and also those guys on the field, too. But game day dishes, it all depends on what they're in the mood for. So they love pasta before the game, so they can, as I said, be firm and strong throughout these games. It's just whatever in the mood for. Like, you know, it changes. Like, they want breakfast, they want pasta, and it's just whatever they're in the mood for to me.
I'm getting hungry talking about, especially this breakfast.
Yeah. So I love like when I do a breakfast buffets even though it's big, and something Mackenzie come over sometime, and Gabe and those guys, but I tend to go all out. I do like shrimp and grits. I do chicken and waffles, and everything I do, I try to do it in a healthier way too, because, you know, your health is all you got, and I care much about these guys, so I try not to compromise that, using stuff whatever I can, or, you know, frozen stuff. Everything is fresh. I try to use organic as much as possible, because as we all know, this is what made their money, right? Their body. So whatever you become, what you eat, you are what you eat. So you just gotta be mindful when you're cooking for these guys.
Absolutely. Now, any plans down the road to maybe open up a restaurant, a food truck, you know, cookbook, podcast, anything? What do you have down the pipeline? Because just, again, looking at your Instagram page, your food looks so appealing and looks so delicious, and we should be able to eat that.
So I do got a cookbook. It's on Amazon right now. It's an ebook. Some people like the hardcover, but I'm still working. I want to work on a like Jamaican favorite cookbook pretty soon. I'm just so busy right now, but I'll be working on that. And I might have something, you know, in the making. Something coming up soon, you know? You guys like surprises, right? But I'm just saying, I do in-home dining, so that's what I've been doing for from July. I've been doing in-home dining, so I'll come to your house. You know, most restaurants are closed. I'll bring the same fine dining feed to your house. I'll come and I transform your entire dining room into a fine dining restaurant. You get the same service even more, because, you know, I was training both areas, so I do it all. Read the menu off to you, I'll guide the guys to the menu, serve you, I got servers, it's legit.
And just to throw it out there, Valentine's Day is coming up, so, you know, that would make a great Valentine's Day, you know, or if you just want to do it on a Saturday, that would make a great present. I know, speaking for the ladies, that we would love to have, you know, our man do that for us. I'm going to just put that out there.
It's funny, because most of these events, they're like more like a surprise. I just did one last night. I have one more tonight. So at times I put on my story like, I'm going to surprise somebody today. I wonder who it is. So everybody's like wondering, is it going to be me? Is it going to be me? So it's fun. It's exciting, you know.
For someone who may want to, you know, utilize those services to surprise their lady, their significant other, their family, or something like that, how can they get in contact with you? And also, please give out your social media as well as the title for your e-cookbook so that people can purchase that.
Yes, so you can find me on Instagram, Chef Darian Bryan. It's DarianBryan. Facebook, Darian Bryan. My website is theplatingsociety.com. My e-cookbook is 15 fresh recipes you can try at home. You can just search my name in Amazon, Chef Darian Bryan. It would show up. And there's 15 healthy, fresh recipes that I created from scratch that you guys can try at home. There's vegan, there's vegetarian. There's something for everybody in there, you know. So that's that for social media. But I'm mostly on Instagram, though. That's where
the pictures are. The mouth-watering pictures.
Yeah, you know, food, and that's it. I post every day on Instagram, every day, because I cook for events and I cook for the guys every day, too. So it's just, there's so much you could learn over there. People wait for me to post to see what they can take. Like, oh, I didn't know you could do that with lamb or with chicken, you know, whatever it is, you know. So there's so much to learn. Let me teach you. Come on, man.
Chef Darian, I enjoy your story and just what you're talking about and how far you've come. And I appreciate you taking the time to share it with us. Thank you so much, and continued success to you.
Appreciate you, sister. Thank you.